PÖFFist te jätkame aga filmidest ja Põhja-Ameerika indie filmide võistlusprogramm, selline asi on ka sellel aastal olemas. Ja täna näiteks linastub filmile pealkiri on Rock and Rolli kuldaeg. See on ühtlasi selle filmi Euroopa esilinastus ka selles samas filmiprogrammis nimetatud siis Põhja-Ameerika indie filmide programmis. Ongi väga palju neid filme, mille esilinastus on Euroopas või siis Ida-Euroopas.
Meil on täna hommikul külas Scott Rosenbaum, kes on selle Rock and Rolli kuldaeg filmi režissöör ja Sandy Mandelberger, kes on Põhja-Ameerika indie filmide võistlusprogrammi koostaja tere hommikust. Good morning. No, Sandy, kõigepealt, mille järgi see programm kokku pandud on, mida PÖFFil praegu näidatakse? Millised filmid te sellesse programmi valinud olete?
What is the basis for the selection of films into the selection?
Well, we wanted to really bring some quality
independent
films from the USA and
Canada,
here to Tallinn, because we think it's very important. We know that you know our Hollywood films, because they're in your cinemas, but there's a whole other industry in the United States and in Canada.
That is this independent filmmakers, new young filmmakers with a lot of visual style, and those films don't get a chance to really be in the cinemas quite so much. So PÖFF is a great forum to be able to showcase this new talent.
Kus näidata neid uusi mõndekaid inimesi
ja võib-olla näidata ka USA teist külge.
No see on selge, et Hollywoodi studiotest tulevad filmid jõuavad igasse maailma nurka sisuliselt. Kui keeruline on sellised sõltumatutest filmistuudiotest tehtavaid filme näidata kuskil mõelda?
Everyone knows that Hollywood movies make it to the cinemas all over the world, but how difficult is it to get the independent movies into the cinemas as well?
Well, independent films do have a struggle to compete because there's a limited number of theater screens. In many ways, they're kind of cousins to European cinema
that also has to fight against the Hollywood machine.
But we know that there's an audience, and also because the films are made for less money, they can get a smaller public.
Ja isegi kui vähem inimesega vaatamas neid filme, siis tehetakse investeeringud tagasi. Ja sõltumatud filmid on ka teisuse hingusega, neid käivad vaatama, kas noored inimesed arvastavad kunstilisi filme, leitakse enda jaoks midagi sellist, mida Hollywoodi filmides ei leia. Ja inimesed on valmis
eksperimenteerima.
Lisaks on need filmid väga meelelahutuslikud ja puudutavad just tänast hetke.
Scott Rosenbaum, mida teie läksid? Otsima sellest Rock and Rolli kuldajastust, millest te filmi tegema hakkasite. Mida te lootsite sealt leida ja mida te tahate publikule siis vahendada?
Why did you decide to make a movie called Perfect Age of Rock and Roll? What were you hoping to find in this Perfect Age of Rock and Roll?
Interesting. Well, I grew up playing in bands and always loving the history of rock and roll.
Erinevates bändides mänginud, ma olen aata armastanud rock and rolli ajalugu.
In the blues as I got older.
Kui ma vanemaks sain, siis ma bluesis avastasin ka rock and rolli alged.
Evolution of the blues music into rock and roll,
and the conflicts essentially between
the development of great music
and
the evolution of rock and roll, and who's really responsible for that music. And we portray that in the film in several ways, between the main character's relationships, as well portraying the evolution of the music throughout the film.
And we try to portray the music development through time.
Natuke nagu rock and rolli ajalugu siis näitav.
So it's a little bit about the history of rock and roll.
It is. Again, it's really the development and the roots of rock and roll.
Rock and rolli areng, millised on rock and rolli juured ja kuidas sellest kasvas välja tänapäevane rock muusika.
Scott, kas tänapäeva muusikas on mingid neid emotsioone ja vibratsioone alles veel, mis eksisteeris muusikas siis, kui mehed olid rauast ja gitarrid olid veel raskemast rauast?
So, do you feel that some of the vibes of rock and roll, when men were made of steel and guitars were made of steel, are in contemporary music as well, or not?
I sort of miss that feeling.
Tegelikult ma tunnen puudus sellest tundest. Ma enam ei tunneta seda tänapäeva muusikas.
Why that is, I think it's in many ways similar to what Sandy was saying about the film industry. I think the artists are out there, but the business has changed.
On huvitavaid artiste, aga tööstusharu on muutunud ja artistidele on raske areneda iseseisvalt.
They had time to establish themselves as musicians and grow, and much like the story in our film, You didn't have just one chance to make an album, and then
näitame seda,
if it didn't succeed, you were
kuidas inimestel
to,
on erinevad võimalusi plaadilepingud saada, nüüd on see valju raskem.
Sandy, need 10 filmi, mis selles võistlusprogrammis on, lisaks nendele ju näeb veel selle sama programmi raames, on nüüd kõige paremad, mis andis nendest sõltumatutest filmistuudiotest siis siia näitamiseks tuua.
So aside from the 10 films in the competition program, there are more films that you're showing during the program. So were these the cream of the crop?
Well, we were able to get films that have been
some
of them at major film festivals in both the US and Europe.
We have quite a number of European premieres here in Tallinn,
and also Eastern European premieres.
But
are making their, so they're early in their career with these films. So they were very anxious to see what the reaction is for the audiences,
ja me ootame ärevusega, milline on publiku reaktsioon.
And in fact, I want to plug that tonight, we are actually showing the European premiere of The Perfect Age of Rock and Roll,
6:30
at the Artist One Cinema. And we actually have one of the bands that's featured in the film,
the Sugar Blue Band,
which is a blues rock band. That's going to be playing at the Quartier Club tonight. So we're very excited to have some live American blues roots music here in Tallinn to accompany the film. It's part of the same spirit of this American independent indie movement.
Muusika vastab ka nendele indifilmide sõltumatule hingusele.
Oletavasti jõuad skotsada need klubid Tallinnas üles otsida, kus meil tehakse veel sellist päris muusikat. Kui ma arvan, Tapper kirjutab endale üles juuksur ja ilmselt see sama korter ka.
So probably you will have time to look up the clubs that still play real music in Estonia. So you should remember some of them. Tapper, Juuksur and Korter.
Yes, sure.
Sa oled täna hommikul tulemas, nii et ka indifilmide programm, mis väga paljuski keskendub muusikale, otsige seegi üles ja saage sellest siis osa. pof.ee on see internetiaadress, mis võiks olla teie päeva juhtideks nendel pimedatel õhtutel, kus Tallinnas, aga ka väga paljudes teistes linnades üle Eestimaa näidatakse väga häid filme.